Hello, fabulous friends and fans. Welcome to your horoscope for the week of July 20th, 2014. I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here. Well, as I spoke about last week, really, it was last week that we started a really important phase. So, as I said last week, wherever it is that you have felt stuck, where you have felt frustrated, where you have felt that you wish movement would happen, you wish energy would rush in, would allow some cleansing, would allow some progress to take place, I do think for a lot of us, we are going to look at the second half of July. We're going to look back at the end of this year, at the second half of July. But also, in possibly for some of us out there, the bigger picture of our lives, we will look back at this very time and realize how much changed, how much actually finally clicked, how much came together, how much we finally understood what it was that needed to happen if we were going to move our lives forward, and ultimately, if we were going to move our lives towards greater love and greater wisdom. And so I look at the fact that, and as I touched on last week, as we start this week, so important, right off the bat, Saturn standing still in the sky, preparing to go direct, what astrologers call stationary direct. But what's also really interesting is that Uranus will be standing still in the sky, preparing to go retrograde, what astrologers call stationary retrograde. So officially, Saturn goes direct on the 20th. Officially, Uranus goes retro on the 21st. That could be off by a day or two, off by a day or so, depending on where you are on this planet. Having said that, it really is as we end last week and as we start this week that this energy is going to be very dominant and very prominent as well, just speaking to a lot of us out there. Now, when Saturn goes direct, it really is truth time. It really is looking at yourself very honestly and looking at the big picture of your life, looking at where you are, and is it going to get you where you actually desire to go? Is it going to take you in a direction of self-respect? Is it going to take you in a direction of tangible results? If it isn't, you will make the changes that need to happen so that you can start moving in a direction that is honoring of our incarnation, honoring of our physical incarnation, honoring that it is one thing to have a dream, it is one thing to believe, and there'll be lots of that this week, I can't wait to tell you that. It's one thing to have the inspiration, it's another thing to actually do it, to actually live it, to actually manifest it. And it isn't so much about actually achieving the thing, but just knowing that you are on that path towards that achievement is huge. It really is to honor our incarnation. And what we also have happening, as I've been saying, Uranus retrograde, Uranus stationary retrograde, is about getting us to get to the place where we are the change we wish to experience. It's turning that Uranian energy. Uranus is all about revolution, rebellion, reinvention. It is a planet of tremendous change. Upheaval, in some cases, yes. But in a lot of cases, what I've found is that ultimately Uranus asks us to be true to ourselves. And where it is that we have not been, that's where the frustration happens. And if we let that build, then yes, Uranus can just sort of in a second say, I don't want to handle this anymore. I'm not going to take this anymore. But it needn't get to that place because Uranus really is a great gift. Uranus is about living true to ourselves and who we've been created to be and not who we've been conditioned to be. And so when Uranus stands still and is going backwards in the sky, as you will over the next few months, this is our opportunity to actually consider and actually make changes within that do allow us to consider what is true revolution, what is true reinvention, what does it mean to actually live true to yourself, what would that look like, what would that feel like within you, what would have to happen in order for you to actually embody the change you wish to experience in your life, the progress, and in some cases the tremendous progress, the leaps you desire to make. Who is it that you need to be today to make that happen for yourself tomorrow? And so we've got this great mix of energy where Saturn is saying, think about tomorrow, think about the big picture. Uranus is saying, align yourself with that. on an energetic level, on an internal level. Now, both these planets are hanging out at 16 degrees of their respective signs, and they are forming, although it's not exact to the minute, they are forming what astrologers call a quincunx. It's a type of conversation that is one of the newer conversations that are known. And what I mean by that is there are certain very basic classical aspects, we call them, but I call them conversations, that take place between planets. And this particular type of conversation might not be considered one of the major conversations for two planets to have, but still, especially in our modern times, really important and a part of just about every astrologer's toolbox out there. And so with this particular conversation, what happens is these two planets, their energy sort of in unexpected and surprising ways have to find a way to get along. They have to find a way to come to some sort of balance, even if it might feel like it just came out of nowhere, this need to find balance between these energies, and it makes no sense. Why would they need to find balance? And yet, here they are. They've got to consider each other. They've got to find a way to work together. And Saturn, as I said, honoring the physical reality, honoring the structure, moving ourselves towards the big picture. Uranus goes a lot more on your insights, your impulses, your desire to really be you. So how do you bring those together? For all of us, in some way, we are going to be experiencing this question. In some way, it's going to come up. But the good thing is that the answer is very strongly indicated. Now, you add to this the fact Mercury's going to be really busy this week as well. And I'll talk more about that in a second, too. It's such an active sky this week. We really are so lucky to be living in such changing times. And as I said, as I opened with, if you have wanted to experience progress, this really could be the time when so much starts changing very much in your favor. Mercury's going to be doing a lot of interesting things this week. He's standing across the sky from Pluto. He's speaking intention, what astrologers call a square to Uranus as well. Okay, so Uranus standing still, newly retrograde, is having this conversation with Mercury. But Mercury is also speaking in supreme harmony with Saturn as well. And so this furthers this idea to me that these two energies are going to have to find a way to get along in your own life. You're going to have to find that balance between honoring the structure, honoring the protocol, looking at how things have been done, recognizing that, looking at the rules and yet breaking them, knowing the rules well enough to actually move beyond them, to actually break them. It reminds me of, and this might fit with some people out there, but I remember in graduate school, Jeffrey Cornelius, and the very first day he talked about how the academic environment had specific rituals that deserved to be honored if you wanted to be part of this environment. And one of those rituals were to understand your opponent's argument. One of the real rituals he talked about was this idea that you've got to understand what the critics are saying before you are willing to really tear down their argument, if you will, before you're ready to challenge that, before you're ready to come up with your own idea, a new idea, build on someone else's idea, bring ideas together. You've got to understand all the different ideas that are out there, especially those that contradict what it is that you believe and what it is that you are trying to say. Understand it enough so that you can meet that person at that same level in order to challenge it with respect and with understanding. And so that was his perspective. That, among other sort of rituals in the academic environment that deserve to be honored, were really very meaningful to me in the beginning of my graduate school career. And that to me really speaks to, that is Uranus and Saturn right there. That is the exactly what Uranus and Saturn is. It's about understanding what is actually happening, what has actually been done before you go out there and break the rules and do something else and do something new. It is respect, and it really is building something that can be a lot stronger if you went about it a different way. So with Mercury involved in this, it does suggest on the one hand, yes, conversation, communication will very much be part of this process. Okay, so do expect to hear news, get messages, have interactions that trigger some of these lessons for you individually. However, also do keep in mind that ultimately Mercury is going to help is going to help these energies work together in your own life. So whatever messages come through, it looks like they're likely to be a surprise, likely to come out of nowhere, but they really do move us in a direction that is more solid, more stable, and really is, as I said, self-respect. Self-respect is really, I think, the essence of what Saturn is about. Faith without works is dead is the essence of what Saturn is about. And Mercury will let you know, thanks to these conversations that are taking place, Mercury will let you know just what it is that you need to do to move yourself towards greater self-respect. So as I said, there's lots of inspiration this week as well. So what we have happening this week is the sun is going to move into the sign of Leo and quickly rush midweek, depending on where you are, right around the 24th of the month, quickly rush towards Jupiter and meet Jupiter in the sky. And on the same day, Venus will be speaking in supreme harmony with Neptune. This to me is so important. This to me is so huge. When I look at this particular conversation taking place, both of these together especially, just if you were to take one, Jupiter meeting the sun, or rather the sun meeting Jupiter, because it is the sun that moves a lot faster. The sun actually comes up to Jupiter and then moves on. This is, some astrologers like to call, the luckiest day of the year. I think what type of luck you wish to court is going to depend a lot on what's happening in your own chart, okay? And also what's happening in the sky for you from your perspective. However, ultimately, I really like this energy. I think there's an energy of faith and an energy of belief, and that really can make amazing things happen and amazing turnarounds happen. If there's anything that you want to start, there is this window of time happening between the 24th and the new moon that happens at the very end of the week in the sign of Leo, that is also working with this energy of the sun and Jupiter together, because this particular new moon is happening right on top of Jupiter as well. And so the three are coming together very powerfully. This really is a great moment to start anything that you really want to start. If there's any seeds you want to plant, any, even if it's a symbolic gesture, this is the time to do it, okay? If you are somebody who has worked in corporate for the last 20 years, but you have a dream of being a rock star, this is the day that you want to actually pen that song, if you will. This is the day, and really it's seed moments, right? This is the day when you actually want to. If your start is joining a website specifically geared towards musicians, that may be it for you. If your particular thing is actually putting a song online, that may be the thing for you. However, if you have been a musician, a rock star all your life, you're getting a little tired about that life and you want to get into business, this is also a really good day to actually do what it is that you feel called to do. Plant some kind of seed, because there will be tremendous blessing energy going along with this. You add to this the fact that because Venus will be speaking in supreme harmony with Neptune, I mean, that conversation to me is just so important to happen at the same time, because it suggests miracles, it suggests faith and belief, and the type of faith that really, as I don't say it lightly, can make really incredible things happen. For some people might feel near miraculous, can really make wonderful things take place. So it really is a great time. If you are an artist of any kind, this is the time not only to devote some attention to your art. If you're a creative person, nurture your creativity, but also do something to share it. Also do something to put it out there on a wider scale. Whether it's a brainstorm that takes place for you in part of the day, and in the other part of the day you are actually sharing something online, those small gestures really utilize this energy and allow you to help this energy build and build and build. Finally, I do want to say that in the later part of the week, just as this new moon is reaching its perfection, if you will, its perfect new moon point, because there's always an instant where things happen. It's the energy building towards it, and yes, after it as well, that we feel a lot of activity happening. So we should be feeling this new moon coming on pretty much all week, but there's so much happening this week. And then after, 2 weeks after the new moon, we're still working with this energy, which is great. What's also happening right around just before this new moon happens is that Mars will change signs. Mars hanging out in the same part of the sky for an unusually long time. I think just about every sign has heard me talk about this at some point in the monthly horoscopes, also in the weekly horoscopes as well. Mars has been hanging out in the sign of Libra since the end of last year. Normally, Mars spends about 6 weeks per sign, spent a good 7 months, 7 months in the sign of Libra. And all of us in some area of life would have had to really look at how we were expending our energy and find our power and make changes in at least one area of life. Now, as Mars moves and changes signs, this also represents a shift in energy that is so important because Mars is a very immediate kind of energy. Mars is the life force. It's the creative energy that we feel that makes us feel alive. And when Mars changes signs, it's like our drive, our focus shifts. What we understand as ultimately where it is our most immediate attention, where we're reacting to the world. What area of life is that coming? That changes. And so this also represents big changes happening for us, a shift in focus happening for us. My goodness, it's such a busy week. I hope I got everything. But there's just so much happening in the sky right now. And I really hope that you take this opportunity to nurture whatever it is that you desire to, plant whatever seeds it is that you desire to, and have faith. First and foremost, have faith. The steps are going to be revealed, okay, slowly but surely. They always are. However, there's so much happening now. And as I said, so many of us are going to look back at this very time and say that was a time when a lot of things changed. And they can change very, very much to your advantage. Well, this is where I say thank you so much. Now we're about to move into the horoscopes for each signs. I do want to give you a very, very heartfelt thank you out there because the views are higher than ever. I've been reaching all these milestones quicker than I thought in terms of the channel views, and I just am so incredibly grateful for that. Thank you so much. I so enjoy your interactions. Have been keeping a list, definitely. The monthly horoscopes should be up in the early part of this week. And I thank you for your enthusiasm, reaching out, asking questions, having interactions with me. I so love it. I just can't tell you how much it means to me and just how much positive energy there is out there. And it's not about me. I'm really of that belief. It's not about me. It's about what it is that all of us are sharing, the energy that all of us are contributing to. And I'm just so grateful that there's something that I am sharing that resonates with you. Now, some people ask astrological questions, so I'm keeping a list and I'm getting through them. So you should be noticing videos come online more and more that have to do with special series, special topics, answering viewer questions as well. Sometimes I'm asked questions that are a little bit more personal, wanting to look specifically at your chart. And I would ask for you to, if you are so inspired, to look into personalized horoscopes. There should be a link on your screen and also in the YouTube description as well. However, as I said, just you being here in this moment really is just so wonderful to me. It's such a great omen to me in my life about us as a collective that there's more and more people who are really interested in consciously connecting with others and consciously nurturing and growing energy in the world that is positive and that really contributes to a growing sense of love and wisdom in the world for all of us as a collective and in our individual lives as well. So thank you for seeing me as some small part of your sacred journey. So how all this wonderful active sky this week speaks to you and your sign is coming up right now. Hello, fabulous Aries. Well, the big news this week, among so much other big news, is the fact I do think the one thing that you really want to focus on is the fact that Mars is going to change signs. This is huge for you. I spoke about this in the August horoscopes, in particular, the love horoscopes for your sign. This really is a shift in energy for you that reaches right to the core of you. It really marks a very important transition moment, a turning moment for you, if you will. And I do see this as being a time when you are coming to understand that much more deeply what it is that has been in love and where it is now that you want to direct your energy. What is it ultimately that is going to empower you? There's an element here that has to do with finances. And so it does look like you are likely going to start thinking about how to empower yourself more on a financial level, what it is that you need to do to feel like you are moving in a direction of greater stability on the one hand, yes, but really building something that can allow you a sense of understanding that on the one hand, what really matters and what doesn't, but on the other hand, really allows you to feel like you're moving towards greater wealth. And however it is you define that emotionally, financially, and otherwise as well. There's also the promise this week of just a lot of love energy in the air for you in particular, given what Jupiter is doing. I spoke about this in the Jupiter special as well. And so there's this healing energy coming in where it comes to love, where love can be fun again. And then at the same time, any kind of conflicts or uncertainty that might have been there will now slowly but surely start to pass. And those of you who are interested in meeting somebody new, this particular new moon should give you an amazing opportunity to meet somebody who possibly could be somebody who ends up being very significant to you now and in the bigger picture of your life. Hello, fabulous Taurus. Well, midweek, it is your ruling planet, Venus, that will be speaking in supreme harmony with Neptune. This is so important. This is so huge. I do see this as a major turning point for you, a major understanding for you that happens. And it isn't, of course, when we look at Venus and Neptune speaking, we don't normally think of this as an understanding. But Mercury is also really active at this time. Mercury moving through a compatible sign to you, Mercury moving through Cancer. You've also got Jupiter having moved as well, switching up that energy for you. And I think all of these things coming together and the fact that this is all happening while your ruling planet is speaking in harmony with Neptune, to me suggests that you are plugged in to the right source. You are plugged in to the right inspiration as well. There is an element here of faith, an element here of understanding that all the people who are in your life are not there by accident. They all are a part of your life, as part of the tapestry that is moving you towards greater love and greater wisdom. I see that appreciation really coming home for you, and home in the spiritual sense, but in the literal sense as well, really coming home for you right around this time. It is certainly a time that's going to ask you to believe in your hopes, believe in your wishes, and believe that you can start doing today the things you need to lay a very strong and solid foundation from which to actually materialize those very big dreams that are coming forward now. Believe in them. You certainly can achieve them. Hello, fabulous Gemini. Your ruling planet, Mercury, is busy this week, standing across the sky from Pluto, as I spoke of in the intro, speaking with Uranus, speaking with Saturn as well. I put all this together and it does suggest, look, Mercury and Uranus speaking in what astrologers call a square. This is a conversation of tension, not always the easiest conversation. However, when these two planets do speak this way, it does tend to suggest news finding you, really shaking up some of what you thought before, what you believed before, the way you were perceiving things before. But it looks like you really like the result because your ruling planet is ultimately speaking in harmony with Saturn. And so I'm really going to advise you, when I look at this, I'll be very honest with you, when I look at this, especially where it comes to any kind of financial talks or financial dealings, because Mercury is in the sign just after yours, which does have to do with things like self-worth, yes, on a sort of spiritual level, but on a literal level, it has to do with earning money as well. Whatever news, whatever information, whatever interaction comes through, on the one hand, you don't want to take it at face value, but on the other hand, if there is anything... any holes, any plans that you've had towards building something more solid, this could be a time when holes are revealed. But also, you know, I gotta say, this is your ruling planet. Pluto is in a part of the sky that has to do with secrets you hold consciously. Again, this is, you know, what you do sort of to earn money. And I would say to you, just really watch how you're interpreting any kind of messages that come through, and be mindful, especially of the kind of messages that you are sending as well, because there is an element here where things can, if you don't connect with that Saturn energy, if you consciously approach the sky and say, you know what, I'm going to give that Saturn energy the strong point here. If you don't consciously stay rooted in that Saturn energy, you might end up saying something that might not be too good in the bigger picture, that might lead you to feel a sense of disappointment. And so you just want to watch your actions, watch how you're interpreting things, and also what you are communicating as well. Before you send it, make sure you look at it and make sure that it can't be interpreted in ways that are not Saturnian, okay? So ground yourself in that Saturn energy. And I do think if you focus on that Saturn energy, you may just have a key conversation that ends up, and especially with somebody higher up, a key conversation in the workspace with a higher up that does lead you towards greater prosperity. Focus on that. It's more fun to do the other stuff, but focus on that and you will find that you make progress, and it's long-term progress towards a stronger financial picture. Hello, fabulous Cancer. Well, Mercury's moving through your sign this week, and so is Venus. Mercury, very active, speaking with Pluto in your opposite sign in particular. And I look at the fact that Venus is there speaking in supreme harmony with Neptune. The only thing that can be said here really is you believe in love, and no one is going to talk you out of it otherwise. And it does look like there may be sort of moments when you're having these conversations with other people in various aspects of your life, particularly in relationships, given that Mercury's standing across the sky from Pluto in your opposite sign. However, Mercury is also speaking in harmony with Saturn, as I spoke of in the introduction as well. And Saturn is in a part of the sky that has to do with love, or the feeling of love that you can have. And I look at all this together, and it does suggest that you believe in love enough to have the tough talk, to have the conversation. And even though I do think that you want to be respectful of each other, because it isn't that everything that's said is just going to be like totally smooth and perfect. But whatever needs to be aired out, if there's more that needs to be aired out, then more will come out. But whatever needs to be aired out, especially in context of love, especially in the context of partnership, if this is a partner, then whatever needs to come out will, and that will strengthen the belief in love, strengthen the bond, if you will, thanks to Venus and Neptune, and also Mercury and Saturn as well. If you are not currently in a relationship, this can be more about love in terms of you understanding yourself and believing in love, that there is love in the universe for you. And this can also play out in terms of a creative project as well. And given that Uranus is speaking to Mercury in your sign as well, there's a strong emphasis there on career. And so this energy can play out, in addition to romantically, can also play out on the career front as well, where you recognize that ultimately whatever it is that you're trying to accomplish, it has to be rooted in the creativity. It has to be rooted in what it is that your instincts are calling you to do. If you honor that, you honor your instincts and the direction in which it's telling you to go, especially where it comes to your work, that's when you utilize the energy here to your advantage and make some really solid gains. Hello, fabulous Leo. Well, your sun changes signs coming into your sign. Very big happy birthday to you. So this is an important month that starts for you. And it starts with such a wonderful, I guess the best way to put it is it's almost like a party, like the sky is having a birthday party for you this week. You have got the sun meeting Jupiter in the sky, and then the moon rushes to meet them both in the sky. And we have this new moon that sort of caps off the end of the week. You add to this the fact that Uranus is in a very harmonious position in the sky for you. And so, and I also think about the fact that Mercury moving through the sign just before yours is speaking in harmony with Saturn, is having conversations with other celestial bodies. I mean, I put all this together and it does suggest to me a time when you are really recognizing what is worth holding on to and what isn't, what you're ready to let go of, what energy you've been holding on to, wherever it is. If there have been any aspects of you where you come to realize that, oh, wow, I've been holding that resentment for a long time now, a lot of years now, That person is long and gone. I don't need to hold on to that anymore. And once you do that, I do think that there's an element here of freedom and really allowing some great blessings to come in. And so, you know, I spoke in the intro about the luckiest day of the year. This goes right to the heart of you. And I do think that this week in particular, you're about to glimpse a vision of yourself and who you could be. And really, it's achievable. Really, there's an element there where you can almost touch it. You can understand that you can make progress. You can move your life no matter where you are in your life, no matter how old you are, no matter how young you are. You can move your life in a more favorable direction, a happier direction, a more fulfilling direction. So what is that going to look like for you? Well, that's something that you are going to connect to this week. And as I said again in the intro, I would advise you to do something, plant a seed, any small, no matter how symbolic action is going to help you tremendously move your life powerfully forward now, but also in the coming year as well. Hello, fabulous Virgo. Well, your ruling planet Mercury is going to be busy this week speaking with Pluto, speaking with Uranus, speaking with Saturn, as I spoke about in the intro. I look at all this happening and it does suggest changes taking place for you on a very important level, on a very deep level. And it does look like people are going to be part of facilitating some very important changes to take place for you. In fact, I do see key conversations happening for you now, possibly between friends as well, that lead to agreements that ultimately I do think can certainly help you on a level of career as well. And so when I look at the sky, I got to say, especially in the earlier part of the week, once Mercury is standing across Pluto in the sky, this could be you facing some insecurity, wondering about whether or not you're really going to find fulfillment on some level. This could also be you sort of, I mean, I look at the fact that Pluto isn't a part of the sky that does have to do with kids, okay? So if you have kids, there may be a part of you that's, you know, uncertain or thinking, I hope that they're doing okay, or I hope that they know what they're doing. That seems to be the sort of dominant question for you in the earlier part of the week. But by the time we get you just a little bit further into the week and Mercury is speaking in supreme harmony with Saturn, it does look like you come to understand that, yeah, what is happening with your children is wise as well. And it looks like you become much more grounded thanks to a conversation. Now, if your kids are old enough, you'll be having that conversation directly with them. If not, it will likely be with a friend, but all that seems to help you to restore a sense of understanding in the process of growing up. No matter how old you are, no matter how old your kids are, we all are always growing up. And so there is that element there where you've got to trust, as part of the wisdom of the universe, that your kids are learning what it is that they need to. If you don't have children, this also can play out in terms of your inner child, in terms of understanding how you're going to care for the child within you. How are you going to be present for the child within you? And so this offers you an incredible opportunity to actually look at what types of conversations are you having within? What types of situations might you be replaying that actually spoke back to your own childhood, spoke back to when you were a child. And this can be a time when you are doing a tremendous amount of growing up, where you see the wisdom in what was, where you see that now it is that you can be a parent to that child within yourself. And that same faith that you would bring to a child that you would have, you can now bring to yourself as well. So it's a lot of healing energy for you right now. It's kicking off big time. We'll be with you throughout the year. And really, this is sort of the root, the beginning of some really powerful self-care and some really powerful steps towards individuation, as Carl Jung called it. And that's really the process of stepping into adulthood. We're always doing that a little more and a little more throughout our lives. And right now, you should take some notable strides in that direction. Hello, fabulous Libra. This week we have Venus speaking in supreme harmony with Neptune, your ruling planet. I look at this conversation taking place right in the middle of the week, and it's almost as if the stuff that maybe might not be so harmonious almost doesn't affect you. It almost doesn't reach you because even though we have Uranus and Mercury speaking, Uranus being in your opposite sign right now, that does denote some tension taking place. However, we've got Jupiter and the Sun meeting in a supremely harmonious placement in the sky for you. We've got your ruling planet moving through a part of the sky For you, that has to do with your career, your real connection and understanding of the big picture of your life purpose. And we have got Neptune making a slow move over the course of this decade and into the next in a part of the sky for you that has to do with your work environment. And so, and also your daily life, your lived experience, your daily rituals. I look at this conversation taking place and I think that there's a lot of hope that your life can move powerfully forward. There's a deep, not only belief, but there is a faith that is playing out that can make really miraculous, in some cases, turnarounds happen in the context of the workspace, in the context of your career space as well. But this is also, as I said, life purpose. This is bigger as well. This is about you thinking about ultimately how high is it that you desire to go in this life? What is it ultimately that matters in the really big picture of your life? You just had a year of really looking at that, examining that, getting a lot of positive energy in that regard. Thanks to Jupiter having just left that same part of the sky. Now you've got Venus moving through there, making sure that you appreciate the blessings that were there. And really reap some blessings now as well. And so I do think that even if you have to have a little bit of a difficult conversation with somebody who's a partner, maybe a business partner, maybe a romantic partner as well, a little bit of a conversation to say, hey, what direction do you think we're going in? How does this fit in with the bigger picture of what we're doing? It does look like it's a conversation that ultimately is going to bring a lot of stability, in particular financial stability as well. And it does look like you are making progress on a lot of fronts, financially, accomplishment-wise, work-wise, really making some strides in a very positive direction for you and really moving in the direction of accomplishing some wishes for your life, finding a way to make that career actually be the source of the income. All of that seems to be coming together for you now, wonderfully so. Really, your main work right now is to have faith that amazing turnarounds are possible for you, amazing progress is possible for you. Nurture that energy, and I think that you will find opportunity just rises to meet you. Hello, fabulous Scorpio. Well, this week we have Saturn continuing to move through your sign. However, a couple of key things are happening. One is we have your ruling planet Mars coming home. So your ancient ruling planet Mars is going to come into your sign late this week. Now, this is huge. It is so important. I would have spoken about this in the monthly videos as well, because this really is you being energized by life, you understanding, ultimately beginning a process now that's going to take you into next month where you get a lot of the lessons that Saturn has been trying to teach you since late 2012 and actually get to demonstrate them. And so what we have happening this week with Saturn standing still, going direct in your sign. Now, this alone is so important. This alone is huge. We have Saturn doing this thing in your sign and Mercury reaching out in supreme harmony with Saturn as well. This tells me that while there are blessings taking place for you on the career front and new moon on the career front as well, speaking powerfully to fresh starts in terms of accomplishment, what it is that you can achieve, I do think that there's an element here as well that speaks to ultimately you understanding what needs to happen, what you need to demonstrate, what you need to give your focus to, what you need to give your attention to if you actually are going to be happy and if you actually are going to take ownership for the happiness that you wish to experience now and that you wish to experience in life as well, in the bigger picture of your life as well. What we also have with Saturn in your sign, newly direct, this is you feeling an important shift of energy. Mars entering your sign, an important shift of energy. Both of these elements are coming forward now, coming together now powerfully for you. And this really is going to speak to some significant changes, sort of the kickoff to some significant changes that are going to take place for you now. You're coming to understand just what you can do to reap tangible results. And just take a little bit of action and you're going to find that those results start finding you rather quickly. And it looks like wherever it has felt a little bit stagnant, wherever it has felt that you weren't so sure what you should do, what direction you should go in, what change you should make, now the universe is going to say, you've got to change, and that change has got to happen right now. And thankfully, that change ends up being tremendously positive for you. Hello, fabulous Sagittarius. Well, once a year, your ruling planet gets a visit from the sun. This week is such a time. But not only that, we've got the new moon happening in conjunction with your sun, right on top of, right with your ruling planet, with the sun, with the moon. All of this is coming together really powerfully towards the end of the week. And so, and you add the element that we have this particular configuration very harmoniously placed to you, as I spoke about in the Jupiter special for your sign. Now, I look at this playing out, and I look at the other things that are happening as well, because, of course, we have the Jupiter special already. You can watch that already. But I do think that with the other elements sort of playing out this week that are also very important, with Uranus also in a very harmonious position, beginning to go backwards in the sky, standing still, going backwards in the sky, this effectively sets up this power of energy for you that is going to be at certain points more prominent than others, but really is going to be operational for you for the coming year. Now, what is really intriguing to me about what's taking place now is this really is a time when one of those more notable events or more notable moments of this configuration of energy, setting up this configuration of energy, is actually happening for you. So you are a fire sign, okay, whether it's your sun, your moon, your rising, you are a fire sign. And then we've got this buildup of energy that's beginning to happen in fellow fire sign Leo, which is also the part of the sky, what astrologers call house. You're sort of the natural, your natural house in the sky is covered by Leo as well. And then the other fire sign has Uranus moving through it throughout this decade. And what that does is these two different planets, these two different occurrences, two segments of the sky are speaking to you in supreme harmony and setting up what astrologers call a grand trine. Now, I've spoken about grand trines before, but this is involving, because you've got Sag there, because you're the Sag energy, you're the Sag placement, this is a grand trine where you are part of it. You are actually positioned in the sky to reap benefit from what's happening in your fellow fire signs. And I do think that this is likely to be a very important week in understanding this process, in understanding how it is that you're going to move your life in a direction that resonates more closely with you, that opens up adventure, that opens up enthusiasm, because a Sag without enthusiasm not only is not a very happy Sag, but when you see a Sag being self-righteous, it's usually because they're not happy. There's something in their life where they're lacking enthusiasm. There's something where they feel that they are not moving towards, that they desire to move towards. Because they have that disconnection happening, that's why it becomes, that energy can turn in on itself a little bit, become a little bit self-righteous at times, sometimes more than others. However, when you honor that creative impulse, when you honor that impulse to really know more of yourself and the world than you did before, that's when you unleash the absolute positive side. You honor the purpose of the incarnation, and you honor really some of the higher spiritual lessons that you're here to learn. And so I do think you're getting these leaps forward in understanding this now. And this week represents such an important time as Uranus stands still and begins to go backwards in fellow fire sign Aries. You are really connecting to an inner motivation. You are really connecting to a source of joy that's within you and understanding just what you need to demonstrate in the world in order to more fully live it. Trust the insights, the instincts, the realizations, the revelations that come to you now, because they actually hold tremendous potential, not only for happiness, but also prosperity throughout the coming year. Hello, fabulous Capricorn. Your ruling planet, Saturn, will be standing still in the sky and will go direct. This is huge and should represent a shift in energy for you. What we also have happening this week is Mercury standing across from Pluto, Pluto in your sign as well. And we've also got Mercury speaking in harmony with your ruling planet, Saturn. I look at this playing out, the fact that Saturn is in a part of the sky that has to do with friendships. It has to do with alliances, any kind of groups you belong to as well. I look at this playing out, and it does suggest to me that really it is going to be people who facilitate you moving forward, facilitate progress in your life now. And I do think it's going to be, on the one hand, there's likely to be some sort of, whether it's a friend who connects you with somebody who can end up being a partner with you, romantic or business, or whether it is you meeting somebody that where it really feels like this person can really move you in the direction of your dreams and of your wishes. That is certainly possible as well. And it's a really solid, really steady kind of energy that's playing out this week. What I also really find really interesting about how the sky is playing out for you is with your ruling planet going direct, this always represents a major turning point for you, where you understand where it is that you have been stuck, where you understand where it is that maybe you weren't allowing the full ease with which the universe can bless your life. Maybe you weren't allowing that so much. Now something shifts for you, importantly so, where you get it, like the proverbial it. And I think a lot of people are going to be getting it, the proverbial it, but for you, it reaches right to the heart of you, reaches right to the core of you, where you understand what adjustments need to happen so that you can experience practical progress. And you're making the right connections, having the right conversations to help you along that path. Hello, fabulous Aquarius. What an important week for you. Really, I would encourage you of all signs to watch the introduction and where I spoke about what is happening with your ancient ruling planet Saturn and your modern ruling planet Uranus. Both of these planets are hanging out in sort of what astrologers, I don't want to get too technical here, but if you're into it, basically both these planets are 16 degrees of their respective signs. They're speaking to each other. I have talked to you about this before. Now with, and as I said before as well, this is a moment of incredible understanding. This is a moment of a shift of energy that finally seems to happen for you. And you add to this the element that you've got this buildup of really positive energy taking place right across the sky from you in your opposite sign. And this does suggest that you are really looking at the direction in which you desire to go, and you understand what actions need to happen if you are going to move yourself in that direction. Powerfully so. And so when I look at this particular, the way that the sky is playing out for you, I don't know how you are going to end this week in the same place that you are as you start this week. In at least one area of life, you are making a significant change, a significant shift. Now, for some of you, it may be your relationship or your relationship status. For others of you, this may play out a little bit closer to the heart, okay? This may play out a little bit more in terms of you understanding ultimately what it is that really matters to you, what it is that needs to happen today to get you to the future you want, but more importantly, what belief, what understanding needs to shift within you so that you can allow that change to happen. So it's almost as if wherever it is that you have felt energy really stagnate, that you have felt energy really stuck, now you understand. There's almost like an internal click where you get it. You go, okay, I understand why I've been holding on or why I haven't been allowing there. And you're able to make that shift. And it does look like a vision of what could be is presenting itself to you. It might not necessarily be in your hands just yet over the course of this week, but the promise is there. And really, the universe has a way of coming together to fulfill its promises to you. So your job is going to be to trust that instinct that you are having to make the changes you need to. Your fixed sign don't like change, and yet you thrive on it because ultimately your sign is one of change. It is one of electricity, of electric waves, of the next thing. You've got to trust that now and allow yourself to make that evolutionary leap, really, that's trying to happen for you now. And also trust that there is better in the universe for you. Absolutely. There's better. There's more inspiring, more hopeful. And it's like, it's almost as if I can see you seeing it It's like you see it, you're looking right at it, and it's really up to you. It's not as far as you think it is. It really isn't. In any area of life, wherever it is that you are desiring that leap forward towards whatever it is that you most want, whatever it is that's closest to your heart that you feel is going to represent a sense of fulfillment, a sense of dreams coming true, this is the time for you to take some action, no matter how small, no matter how symbolic, in that direction. And if you are one of those people who is open to love, or you're in a partnership, you want to solidify that partnership, this is a week where you want to take some small, symbolic, no matter how symbolic, some action to affirm to the universe that love is abundant and that love is available to you. Now, that doesn't mean that your relationship status might stay the same this week. For some, it might solidify even stronger. For others, you may realize that you're in a situation that isn't working for you, and you've got to have faith that there is love out there for you. For others, it will be a more universal understanding of love, understanding that the love you've been wanting has been within you all along. And however it is that this energy manifests for you, it looks like such an important moment where you understand the value of love and the love that you have to give. And that in turn leads you to make a very valuable decision that certainly will move you towards greater love and greater wisdom. Hello, fabulous Pisces. Well, your ruling planet, your ancient ruling planet, Jupiter, is being met by the sun this week. And at the same time, on the same day, we have Neptune, not the exact same time, but on the same day, we have your ruling planet, your modern ruling planet, Neptune, speaking in harmony with Venus, and Neptune in your sign at that. And you put these together, and it does suggest a time when you are feeling like you've plugged right into source. The best of you is coming forward. There's a lot of creative energy at your disposal as well. And it's up to you to trust that. If you're an artist of any kind, allow that to come forward. So there's been a lot of this building of creative energy taking place, and this is one of the peak moments for you. I do think also that given that we have this really harmonious conversation happening between Venus and Neptune, and ultimately this is about fueling your creativity and believing in your creativity, you want to nurture that. But also, because of what your ancient ruling planet is doing, as I spoke of in the intro, tangible action is going to be so important for you as well. And there's going to be that desire, there's going to be that impetus to kind of just put a stronger emphasis on the faith and on the energy. And that's great. You can do that. But don't let that get in the way of tangible action. What we also have happening this week and the end of the week is that Mars is going to move into fellow water sign Scorpio, very harmonious to you. And this tells me that you are understanding action much more differently. And you are understanding what action you need to take, what adventure you need to embrace, what enthusiasm you need to nourish and you need to raise if you're going to move your life in a direction that you like. It looks like the vision is trying to open up to you as to what could be. Now, it's not just about trusting it, because it looks like the trust is there, the faith is there, but about you starting to move yourself towards it. If there ever was a sign that needed to take some action, no matter how symbolic, it would be you. But if you can do that, if you can embrace that, I think you're going to find that very quickly you're actually building momentum, where it isn't just about the action that you take, however small symbolically, but that leads to another action. You go, oh, wow, okay, I could do this, I could do this, this could be the next, this could be the next. And then trusting that process, going with that process, going through it one step at a time, one moment at a time. And I do think that all of that is going to come together so nicely for you, not only this week, but in the coming weeks as well. So your job is connect with the dream and stay connected in that. Believe the universe is on your side, but then act from that place as well. Well, I will stop there. Thank you so much to all signs out there. It'll be a great week. It truly will be a great week. Lots happening this week. Lots of change happening. I'm so inspired by it. I hope you are too. It'll be a great week. Enjoy.